Today we are going to discuss the important topic of the today's lecture, the TV presentation. In the previous lecture, we assumed that what are the basic properties of the tree, how the tree are designed, what are the different characteristics are there, what are the different kind of the trees are there. Today we will talk about the traversing in the tree. By the traversing, we mean that if you want to access the every element of a tree in some particular fashion, so that we are able to process each and every node of a tree, or we are able to display all the elements of a tree at least once, then we are saying it is a traversing of a tree. If we talk about the linear array, then in the linear array of the linear linked list, we are able to traverse in one particular direction, because in the linear data structure, if we are at one particular node, then we can access all the nodes in the moving through in the one particular direction. But as we know that the tree is a non-linear data structure, so in the tree there are the various ways are there through which we can traverse in a tree. So those are known as the different kind of a traversing are there. So basically there are the four kind of a traversing are available in the tree. That is, we are saying is a pre-order, in order, post order, and next one is the level order. So these are the four ways through which we are able to traverse in a tree. So this ordering is actually depends on the how we are accessing the nodes in the tree. As we know that we are having the three parts as a part of a node in the tree. One is the data, or in other terms we can say that we are having the different things over here. One is called a root of a tree, then it is the left child or the left subtree, then it is a right child or right subtree. So how we access them? It depends on the order. If we say that the pre-order, it means to say that we access the root first, then the left child, then the right child. So ordering of the root depends the said order. Pre-order means we are accessing the root first, then the root, then left, then the right. If we say in order, so we will say left, root, and then the right. If we say post-order, so we will say left, right, and then the root. And then level order means we are going through each and every level in a tree. So this way we define the ordering of a traversing. So we start with the pre-order. Pre-order is also known as the depth first traversal. Means we access, we go through in one particular path, one particular level. In the we start from the left, so we start going through left and left and left up to the leaf node. Then we start traversing in the backward direction. So we say the pre-order is that their first traversal. It is also used to calculate the prefix of any arithmetic expression. We have seen the prefix representation of an arithmetic expression. So same can be applicable over here in calculating the pre-order traversing of a tree. Let's look at the one of the example of the arithmetic expression. Let's say expression is given as a minus b plus c into d. If we construct the tree over here, so if the tree will be like this, plus minus a b into c and d. So this is the tree representation of this arithmetic expression. Now we have to calculate the pre-order of this. So pre-order will be that we start from the root, then we go through with the pre-order is the root, then left, then the right. So we start from the root, then we come to this root, then left, then right. Once the left part of this root is over, then we will take the right part, then again we follow the same procedure, root, then left, then the right. So we start from the root, so that is plus, then root, left and the right. So left is again we come at this part, again we start the same procedure in the recursive way on the subtree, so we take the minus as a root, then left, A, then right. So this left part is over, root is over, then come to the right part, then multiply, then C, and then A. So here you can see that this is the prefix representation of this arithmetic expression. So we can get the prefix notation of any arithmetic expression by forming a tree and then converting those or reversing those in the pre-order form. So it's the prefix representation over here. Let's take some more example through which we can convert a tree or we can traverse a tree in the pre-order traversal. The example is, let's say A, B, C, D, E, suppose the tree is given to us and we have to form a pre-order traversal. Pre-order is root, left and the right. So we start from the root, A, root is over, then come to the left, again in the left, the root, B, then left, come to here, then it is a root, D, then D is over, then root, left, G, left is over, then right, right, so H is root, H, then it does not have any left, then the right, so L. So this part is over, so for the B, the left part is over, then right part, E. So this E is over, then we can cover the left part of A and root is over. So root and left is over, then come to the right. Now in the right, C is the root, root, then C does not have any left, come to the right. In the right, again F is the root, F, then left of F, I, then right of F. Right of F is J is the root, so J and then the K. So this is the pre-order traversal of the tree representation. Now next is the in-order traversal. In-order traversal is that when we have to form the symmetric representation over here. So in this case we use the in-order traversal. In-order traversal is that we start left, then root, and then the right. So if you want to represent an arithmetic expression in the same way, if the tree is given to us and we have to convert those in the form of the arithmetic expression, so we can represent the same thing as it is. Like this is the tree representation over here, and if you have to convert this in the in-order traversal, it is like this. We start from the left, so we start from the root, then left, then left, then left. So we start at the left, then we take the first left, G, left. Then the root of this, D. Then the right of this. So we come to the H. Now H does not have any left. So we take H, then right, L. So the left part of the B is over. Then take the root, B. Then take the right, E. Now this left part of the root A is over. So left, then root, so A, then the right. Now at the right, we are at the C. Now C does not have any left. So the left part is removed, then the root, then the right. So come to the right. Right, we are having F. Then here, I is the left, so I. Left is over for the F. Then the root is F, then the right. So here again, we take J is the root, then K is the left. So K and then the G. So this is the in-order traversal of a tree. So if you represent the same thing as it is at the ground, so we will get the in-order traversal of a tree. Now the next one is the post-order traversal. Post-order traversal is that it is said as a when we are traversing the root at the last. The traversing order will be that we will start from the left, then right, and then the root. So first we will access all the left, then we will access all the rights, then we access the root at the last. So if we take that same tree and we start traversing over here, so we start from the root, then take the left, B, take the left, D, then take the left, G. So we start from here, G is left, follow D, the left part is over, then come to the right part. At the right part we are in H, H does not have any left. So left is over, then right, L, left, right, then the root. So now we will get the H. Now further D, left is over, right is over, then take the root. So we will get D here. Now further B, left part is over, then take the right part, E. Now left and right are over for the B, now we will get the root, B. Now for the A, left part is over, then take the right part. At the right, we have the C. C does not have any left, now take the right. In the right, we have F as a root and I as a left. So take the left first, I. Then take the right. At the right, we are in the J as a root, then the K as a left side. So take K, left is over, then at the right, we does not have anything, so then the root, so J. So now for the F, the left is over, right is over, then take the root. So it is F. Now for the C, left is over, left was not there, right is over, then take the root. So C. Now for the A, left part and the right part both are over, then we will get the A at the last. So this is the representation of a post order traversal of a tree. Now take the level order. In the level order, we are accessing the nodes of a tree in a level wise. We start from the root, then take all the nodes at the next level, then take all the nodes at the next level, and so on up to we get our tree is terminated and we are at the leaf node. So the level order is also known as the breadth first search. As we are accessing all the nodes up to one level, so we are saying it is a breadth first search. But the pre-order is known as the depth first search, that we are accessing all the nodes, we are going to the left, 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 and left at one particular depth, and I am reversing back to the previous level. So in the level order, we start reversing it like this. We start from the root A. So 0th level is over, then take the next level, B, C, all the nodes at this level, B and C, then D, E, F at this level, then G, H, I, J, and then L, and then the B. So these are the level order. We are accessing all the nodes of a particular level starting from left to the right. So this is it. So this is the representation over here of a tree. Now next we are going to discuss about the Hoffman tree. Hoffman tree is another variation of a, or we can say that another application of a binary tree. So Hoffman tree is an entropic coding algorithm that is developed by the David A. Hoffman. The Hoffman is widely used when we have to perform the lossless data compression. It is actually a compression technique in which is taking the help of the binary tree representation. It used the variable and code table to import the source character. Every character that we have to import, we will convert those characters in the form of the code representation, and we are taking the help of the variable length code representation here. So variable length code table is derived based on the estimated probability of the occurrence of each source character. Means how much time that particular character is occur in the given string. Based on that, we calculate the probability of that character and we assign the variable length code to that particular character based on the occurrence or based on the probability of it. So it encodes the most common character with the shorter string and very less common character with the larger string. So like for example, the most common characters are A, E, I, R, S, and these are the most common characters are there in a string. So we assign the very we assign the code of the very less length to this character, and like the character X, Y, Z, and so on. So these are the very less common over here. So in this case, these characters are very rarely used, so we assign the larger length over here. So in this case, the tree representation is done like this. So Hopman algorithm is used to find a tree with the minimum weight path length. So this is the way we can reduce the length of a tree. Now how it is working? A node can be either a leaf node or the internal nodes. All the nodes that we have to form, we have to design a code for this. All of those characters are available in the form of a leaf node in a Hopman tree. Initially, all the nodes in a tree are a leaf node, and they store the source character and its frequency. The character and how much time are the frequency of opening of that character within the string. So we put all the characters in the form of the leaf node in the tree. Then we form the internal nodes from those leaf character. The internal nodes contain the sum of the total occurrence of those character as in the form of the internal nodes. So it stored the weight of those child nodes in the form of the internal nodes. External nodes contain the actual character, internal nodes contain the weight of the child, total weight of the child nodes. We use the 0 to represent that we are following the left subtree or the left child, and we use the 1 to represent that we are following the right child or the right subtree. Then we calculate the external path length. External path length is that the total length or the total distance of external nodes from the root of a tree. So external path length is that we calculate the sum of all the external nodes, the length of the path from the root to the all the external nodes. We calculate the sum of all those, all such kind of the nodes, and we derive the what is the total external path length of all the external nodes from the root. In the same way, we calculate the internal path length. Internal path length is that what is the length of all the internal nodes from the root of a tree. So in this way, we calculate the total internal path length. And once we have got the external path length and internal path length, so we can calculate the formula like this. Then like AI plus 2A equals to AE, where N is the total number of internal nodes. AI is the length of internal nodes. That is the internal path length, and AE is the external path length. So external path length is equals to the internal path length plus the twice of the internal nodes. Let's look at the one example. Suppose the tree is given to us. In this, all the circles are representing internal nodes, and all the squares or all the rectangles are representing the external nodes. Now we have to calculate the internal path length and the external path length. Now the internal path length is calculated like this. The internal path length, like these are the internal nodes here. So we calculate the length like this. Like for this node, we want to calculate the length. So the distance of this node from the root is 2. This is the 1, this is the 2. Or we can say that the distance from the root. So for this node, the distance is 2. For this node, the distance is 1. And for the root, the distance is 0. So this is at the 2 level distance, it is the 1 level distance, it is at the 0. Now for this node, the distance is 1. For this node, the distance is 2. For this node, the distance is 1, 2, and 3. And for this node, the distance is 1, 2, and 3. So the total distance we are getting is 12. That is the internal path length is 12. Now if we calculate the external path length, so external path length is the length of all the external nodes from the root. So if you take this node, then it is at the distance of 2. If you take this node, so these are all, this is at the distance of 1, 2 and 3. Same for this node, 1, 2 and 3. Then this node, 1 and 2. Then this node, this is at 1, 2, 3, 4. Same for this, 4, 4 and 4. So we will calculate the total over here. That is 26. So the external path length is 26, internal path length is 12. Now if you take that formula, so we will say here that internal path length plus twice the number of internal nodes. The number of internal nodes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That is 7 is equals to 26. So that is 12 plus 14 is equals to 26. So we have got over here. That is, the sum of the external path length is equals to sum of internal path length plus twice the number of internal nodes. Then take another example. Suppose this is the tree given to us and we have to calculate the external path length for this. So external path length will be calculated. That is the external path length. So for this node, this having the weight is 2. So and having the distance 1, 2 and 3. So we will say 2 into 3. It is having the weight is 3 or the frequency 3. And it is at the distance of 3. So 3 into 3 plus this at a distance of 2. So 5 into 2 plus it is in a distance 1, 2 and 3, so 11 into 3 plus this at a distance of 1, 2 and 3, so 5 into 3 plus 2 into 2. So we calculate this. That is equals to 77. So we can calculate the external path length like this. Now let's look at the algorithm to form the half-wave tree for a given number of nodes. So the algorithm is like this, that we will create a leaf node for each character. The every character that is occurring in the string will calculate the frequency of number of occurrence, or we will calculate the priority of those characters within the string. So we will calculate for the we will create a leaf node for each character of the string. Then we will add the character with its weight or the frequency of occurrence to the priority queue. We will form the priority queue with the other characters and their occurrence or their frequency. Repeat the step 3rd to 5th, that is 3rd to 5th, while the total number of nodes in the queue is greater than 1. Now we will remove the 2 nodes from the queue who is having the lowest weight or the lowest frequency, highest priority and the lowest frequency. Then we will merge both of those 2 nodes together and create a new internal nodes with the weight is equal to the sum of both the 2 lowest weight nodes. So we will create a new internal nodes by merging those 2 nodes as a children. with the weight equals to the sum of the two nodes' weight. Then we'll add the newly created node to the queue. So this keep on repeating up to we are left with the single nodes in a queue, and that is the total weight we will get here. So let's look at the example. Suppose we are given the different A is occupying 7, B with the 9, C with the 11, D with the 14, E with the 18, F the 21, G with the 27, H with the 29, I with the 35, and the J with the 42. So these are different characters was there in the string, and we have converted the occurrence of those, and then we arrange all of those characters in the priority queue based on the number of occurrence of those characters. Now the second step is that we take the list two characters or the two characters with the shorter occurrence or the shorter value and merge them together and insert the new node in the tree. So let's take the two nodes over here. We'll take A with the 7 and B with the 9. These two nodes we have taken, merge them together, so we'll get the new node with the weight 16. So this 16 is added over here. This two node is over. Now take the next two nodes with the least value. Now this node is also computed in calculating the weight. So now the lowest is the 11 and 14. So take this two. So that is C with the 11 and D with the 14. Take these two, merge them together, so we will get the here value 25. Now these two nodes are over. So we have got the two nodes, one is with the 16, another with the 25, and these are the remaining one. So we have merged both of them together. Now again find the list two. Now the list two are 16 and 18, because 20 and 25 is having a higher value. So we merge both of them together, 16 and 18. So here we will take 18. That is E with the 18, we merge them together. So we will get a new node over here, that is with the value 34. So this node is also over, E is over. Now we are left with the 34, 25, 21, 27, 29, 35 and 40. Now take the again list 2. So list 2 are 21 and 25. So merge them together. So this is F with the 21. Merge them together. We will get the new node over here with the value 46. So this path here, F is over with the 21. Now we are left with the this 6 values within the queue. Now take the list 2, so that is 27 and 29. So take this 2, that is G with the 27 and H with the 29. Merge them together, we will get a new node over here with the value that is 49 and 56. So this new value we got 56 over here. These two nodes are over. Now take the again another list 2. So that is 34, 46, 35, 40 and 56. In this list 2 are 34 and 35. So merge them together. So take here 35. That is I 35. Merge them together. So we will get 69 over here. So this 35 is over. Now the remaining values are 69, 46, 56 and 40. Again take the list 2. So 46 and 40. So that is J with the value 40. Merge them together. We will get the new value here. That is 86. So this part is also over. Now these are the 3 values we are left. 69, 86 and 56. Now merge them. Again take the list 2. So we will take the list 2 over here that is here we got 56. We are forming the tree again over here, G27 and H with the 29. Now merge them together. Let's we remove this for this space. Merge them together. So this tree is here. We remove this. Now merge them together. 56 is this is it will become. So we have merged them together, so we got 125 here. Now we are left with the 125 and 86. This is the one tree, this is another tree. Now merge both of them together. So we get another node over here. That is equals to 2 here. So this way we can form the new tree, or the we can say the augment tree based on this, based on the frequency of augments of those. So this double tree is formed. So this was the algorithm to create the augment tree from this. Now if you have to perform the data coding, based on the augment tree concept. So if any set of character is given to us and we have to form the code of this, so how we can do this? So that can be done. That data coding is actually we are using the bits to convert any character in the form of the code representation. So if we are having the R code with us, then we can use, we can code 2^4 character, 2^r character. If I have the R code, so we can represent or we can code the 2^r character by that. Let's for example that if you are having the 1 code, if the length of the code is 1, or we can say that R beta code. So if the bit is 1, that bit 1 can be either it can be 0 or it can be 1. So if you are in the 1 bit, so we can say that we can represent 0 to the A, we can be 1 to the B. So here we are saying that it is the length of the code. So this is the 1 bit. 1 bit can be either 0 or 1. So we can assign 0 to A, 1 to B, or can vice versa, that 1 to A or 0 to B. Anything can be taken out here. So we can represent 2^r character by that. Let's say that if you are in the value of R is 2, we are in the length of the code is 2 bit. So it can be, the 2 bit can be 00, 01, 10 or 11. So we can say 00 can be assigned to A, B, C and the D. So we can now represent the 4 characters with the help of this. The 2^2, there is 4, so 4 characters can be coded by the this thing. In the same way, if you say that R is equal to 3, so in that case, the length of the code will be after 3 rate data, so 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, and 111. So we can convert, we can say it can be assigned to A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H. Let's say now that suppose the character string is given to us, let's say A, B, B, A, C, D, H, G and F. Suppose this is a string given to us and we have to form a coding of it. So we can perform the coding by this. So A can be assigned the value 000, B can be assigned the value 001, another B 001, A 000, C with the value 010, D with the value 011, H with the value 111, G with the value 110, and F with the value 101. So we have converted this string in the form of the code like this. So this is the conversion over here. Now this kind of the conversion, this kind of the coding is called the fixed length coding, in which every character has assigned the fixed length. The size of the length is fixed, right? So the fixed length coding is very rarely used because it occupies the more space. Here we does not know that which character is have the more frequently occur and which character is less frequently occur. So we use another concept over here that is called the variable length. The variable length, as I told you, that variable length coding is used based on the frequency of occurrence of those character. Means how which character is most frequently occur and which character is less frequently occur. So character which is most frequently occur has assigned the shorter length string, shorter length code, and the character which is less frequently occur has assigned the larger length code. So the by using the variable length coding, we are able to save the space. So how that thing taken place? That thing is taken place with the help of the Hoffman tree. So in that case, first we have to generate the Hoffman tree of the character based on the occurrence of those character. The most most frequently occur character are just placed near to the root, and the less frequently occur characters are placed far distance from the root. So if you are having the character as a just near to the root, then the length of those characters will be less, and if the characters are very far from the root, then the length of those characters will be the large. So let's look at the example. Here the root. Suppose this is a tree given to us, and we are saying that A and E are most frequently occur, so they are placed near to the root. X, Y, Z, and W, they are the less frequently occur, so they are placed at the distance from the root. Now, as I told you, that if you are accessing the left child, then we will say it as a 0. If you are accessing the right child, we will say it as a 1. So it is 0, 1, it is 0, 1, it is 0, 1. It is 0, 1, it is 0, 1, 0, 1. Everywhere you will follow the same procedure. Left is 0, right is by the 1. Right is. Now, calculate the Hoffman code for every character. For the A, we start writing the code from the root to the particular child node. So, let's say EA. So, A is having the code 0, 0. E is having the code 0 and this is 1. So 0, 1. Then R is having the code 1, 1. Then X is having the code 1, 0, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0, 0. That is 1, 0, 0, 0. Then Y is having the code 1, 0, 0, 1. W is having the code 1010, and the Z is having the code 1011. So this is the way we can convert. Now here we can see that the length of the code is very less for the most frequently occur character A, E, R and this. For the X, Y and Z, the length of the code is larger. So based on that we can convert, and this algorithm is used for the compression. So this was about the Hoffman tree. Next we'll talk about binary search tree. Binary search tree, it is the another variation of the tree. Like in the previous class, we have seen, we are talking about the strictly binary tree, full binary tree, complete binary tree, Hubman tree and so on. So in the same way, there is another thing over here, that is a binary search tree. Binary search tree, we say it is a ordered tree, in which the nodes are arranged based on some particular order. That which node will come at the left subtree, which node will come will be at the right subtree. So nodes are arranged based on certain order. So that's why it is called the ordered subtree. So in the binary search tree, the rule is there that all the elements that are come at the left of the root. This is at the left of the root. So value of all of those nodes will be less than the root. And all the nodes that will come at the right of the root will have the value greater than the root. So same procedure is followed at complete tree at every level. We will follow the same procedure. That all the value which come at the left of the root will have the value less than the root. All the value that come at the right of the root will have the value greater than the root. So that's why the nodes are arranged based on this order. So that's why it is called the ordered or the binary search tree or the ordered tree. So here, if we are having the tree like this, so it is very easy to search a particular element within the tree. Because at every level we are reducing our tree just half. We'll come to know that whether we have to go at the left side or whether we have to go at the right side based on the value of that node. If the value of node is less than the root, so we'll follow completely to left and we'll discard the right subtree. In the same way, if having the value greater than the root, so we'll follow completely at the right subtree and we'll discard the left. And the same procedure is applicable at every level within the tree. So at every time we are reducing the size of the tree at the just half of that. So let's look at the example. Suppose we have designed a tree 50, 38, 27, 45, 16, 30, that is 41, 47, then 14, 25, 17, 16, 78, 64, 62. Here you can see the arrangement of the data that we are having the root value is 50. All the value less than the 50 are available at the left side. All the value greater than the 50 are available at the right side. In the same way, the 38 is the subtree, but it is the root of the subtree. So all the value less than 38 is at the left side. All the value greater than 38 is at the right side of this. So same rule is applicable everywhere within the tree. Now within this tree, if I have to search any element, then I will start reading from the root. Let's say for example that I am looking for the 30, I am looking for the 25. So I start from the root. I compare 25 with the 50. This 25 is less than the 50. So I will follow the left. I will discard all the nodes available at the right subtree. Then I will compare 25 with the 38. 25 is less than 38. So I will follow again the left and I will discard the remaining right. So at every level, the right part, here we discarded right, then here we discarded right, now come over here. Now compare 25 with the 27. It is again less than the 27. So we will follow the left and discard the right. Again come at the 16. Now here compare 16 with the 25. As 25 is greater than 16, so we will discard the left and follow the right. And we will got a node over here. So we are, every time we are reducing the size of a tree as a just half. So then we can say that searching become more easier, more faster in the binary search tree in compared to the linked list. Now if you compare our tree with the linked list and the arrays, so you can say that in the case of the arrays, if you are having the sorted array, so in the sorted array, searching of any element is very fast, but the insertion and the deletion is time consuming. More time it is taken to insert and delete any data in the sorted array. In the same way, if you take the linked list, so in the linked list, the insertion and the deletion of any node is quite easy, very fast. But if you have to search any element within the linked list, then it is very time consuming approach. But in case of the tree, in that tree, if you have to search any element, then the searching of element within the tree is very fast. In the same way, the insertion and the deletion of any element within the tree is again very fast. So we can say that the tree is the better in various operation in the incompatible arrays and the linked list. Now this tree is given to us, let's say suppose we have given some data to us, from this data. So how we'll do it? We start from this first node, 45. Take this as a root. Take the 39. 39 is less than 45. So 39 is here. Then 56. 56 is greater than 45. So it came over here. Then 12. We start from 45, less than 45, left. Less than 39, left. So 12 is here. Then 34. 34, less than 45. Less than 39, greater than 12, so 34. Then 78, greater than 45, greater than 56, 78. Then 32, 32 less than 45, less than 39, greater than 12, come out here 35, 34 less than 34, so 32. Then 10. So less than 45, less than 39, less than 12, 10. Then 89, greater than 45, greater than 56, greater than 78. So we will put here 89. Then 54, greater than 45, but less than 56. So 54 came only. Then 67, greater than 45, greater than 56. But less than 78, so 67. Then 81, greater than 45, greater than 56, greater than 78, but less than 89, so here we will get 81. So this is the way we construct a binary search tree from the given set of data with this we complete